Melanie, and today we're going to be working 10 minutes with posture and leg work. We're going to start out against a wall, so at home, if you could find a wall space where you have enough room to bring your arms out to your sides, that's what we're going to do for the first part of this. And then we're going to do some leg work. So you're going to want to, for that, you're going to need a table or a counter or even the back of a chair. So for now, Wendy's going to assist me, and we're going to start against the wall here. So to set yourself up, you want to have your feet about hip distance apart. You're going to bring them away from the wall, so at least 12 inches, maybe a little bit more. You want to easily see your toes. Have a slight bend in the knees to start with. And then we're going to try to flatten ourselves against the wall. So as we do this, think about coming nice and tall. Ideally, you have your head back and tuck your chin. Now, if your head doesn't reach, if you're a little bit forward, think about lifting through crown of the head, chin tucks in, and you might not reach all the way. Don't force it because I don't want your chin to come up. Otherwise, we're against the wall here. Now you're going to imprint your spine. So you're trying to take that space, any space out that you can. So pushing your back against the wall and then pushing your shoulders back. And to help with this, we're going to have our elbows bent and in the wall. And then we're going to try to open those arms up. Now again, if you can't get them all the way, that's fine. You can rest right here. You're still going to get a great stretch in through the chest, and you're going to feel this in the core. So we're going to hold that against the wall. So already kind of working hard. As we do that, it glues our shoulders back, but then our back pops off. Yep, and then you got to push that back again. So you push that back and the shoulders want to pop off. So you keep fighting back and forth, trying to get your whole body back against the wall and your head as well. From here, we're going to do the upper body first, then we're going to add our legs. So right here, inhale, and on that exhale, you're going to slide your hands up. Now, make sure your shoulders go down as you do this, and you don't have to go all the way. So you don't want to let the elbows go past the shoulder area. So Wendy, go ahead and show that part, and I'm going to show a modification. So if you need to be down here, that's fine. If you want to just stay here where you're opening up, that's also fine. So these are just some different options. Okay, from here, we're already working hard. We're going to add in that leg slide. So it's inhale, exhale, coming down until you can get the legs parallel with the floor. You don't want to let your butt dip down any farther than your knees. And if you don't want to come this far, that's okay too. Holding it here for about 10 seconds. So we've got about 5 more. 4, 3, 2, 1. Slide it back up and take a little break. It's a lot of work. Did you feel that?
Oh yeah.
Yeah. So I think we'll do 4 more of those and that will be plenty. Okay, it goes a little bit faster now for the setup. So feet are coming out, knees have a slight bend. Get yourself imprinted. Push those shoulders back, open the arms up so elbows are nice and wide. Inhale, exhale, slide those arms up. Hold that, inhale, exhale, slide down the wall. So you're in that imprinted spine still, shoulders are back, legs in parallel, just holding here. I have my legs together. Legs together or in parallel are fine. So holding here, another 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slide it back up. And roll the shoulders out.
To just get a break in between.
Get a little break, yes.
Okay.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. 3 more to go. So feet are out. Reset your spine. Get it imprinted. Shoulders back. Open those arms up. Inhale, exhale. Slide the arms up. Inhale, exhale. Slide the legs down. Holding it here for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And slide it back up. Take that little breather. We're more than halfway. 2 more. Okay. Setting yourself up again, knees slightly bent, press against the wall, arms open nice and wide, slide them up, make sure those shoulders are pressing down as the hands slide up, shoulders go down. Inhale, exhale, slide the body down. Hold for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Slide it up. Start to feel that after doing a few of those, don't you? One more. All right. Last one here. You can do this. Flatten against the wall. Get those shoulders back. Inhale, exhale. Slide those arms up. Keep your chin down. Inhale, exhale. Slide the body down. Holding it here. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bring it up. All right. Roll those shoulders out. Okay. That was the first half of our series. Now you need to find a countertop or a table or even a sturdy chair to hang on to for the next part.
Okay, see you.
Hi. Hi, Melanie again, and now we're going to start with our leg series. So if at home, you're probably not going to have a bar, so I'm going to let Wendy work at the bar here, but at home you can use a chair, you can also have a table or counter, so preferably something rather stable. This is a little bit unstable, so I have a weight here that I'm going to use to make it more stable for me. So at home you can have somebody sit there or put a weight down, whatever you have in place, or your dog can sit there. That was Wendy's idea. As long as he's not going to run off. Okay.
So reliable.
Right? So coming up to your table, I want you to come think about coming up nice and tall with your posture, shoulders down. So always setting yourself up before we begin. So we got nice tall posture. We're going to start with a Pilates stance of the feet. So toes out, heels together. So just warming the calves and the feet up. From here, it's inhale, and on that exhale, lift those heels up, and when you drop down, let the toes come up. So it's exhale up, inhale down, lift those toes. Exhale up, inhale down, and lift. Exhale, and keep going. Going for 10 here. Feel your glutes engage as you lift those heels up. Everything engages strongly. Stay nice and tall, shoulders stay out of it. Keep them relaxed. Let's do three more. Three. Two.
That toe raise really adds a lot.
Last one. Okay, yeah, it does, doesn't it? Like, oh, it seems simple. Okay, from here, we're going to just get our hamstrings ready for the next set. So we're going to stretch them out a little bit first just to kind of get them ready. So I'm going to pull this out and let Wendy demonstrate this one. So she's just going to stretch those hamstrings out. Good. Then you're going to bring, let's have you bring your left leg so you can see better behind you. Inhale here, keep yourself nice and stable through the torso. You're going to exhale and lift that foot up till it's level with the body. So we want everything in a pretty straight line. So inhale back down and exhale lift. Now I'm going to let Wendy show what not to do, which is to let that pelvis drop and then let it lift up as you raise that leg up. We're not doing that. We're keeping it very level. As you inhale that leg down, tap the toes, exhale, lift it up. So we're isolating the movement right into the hip. And really working on the glutes. Exhale, lift, good. Inhale down, exhale, lift. Let's do five more, and lift. Inhale down, and lift. Three more. And now the other thing she's demonstrating really well is she's keeping those shoulders down. So stabilizing through here, not letting the shoulders come up to the ears. Last one, good job. On this next one, leave that leg up. And now you're going to open this whole side up. So you're going to rotate out to the side. So if your left leg's up, you're rotating to the left side. Hold it there for just a moment. And then you're going to drop that hip back down and even rotate below the right hip. So it comes down and you get a nice stretch in there on that right side.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. Awesome. And then go ahead and lift that side again and bring it back down. Good, and this whole time she's doing this, she's got her heel right in alignment with her hips. Bring it down, and that's going to give you the best stretch here.
It's a tough place to stretch.
It is. Really, this is a tough exercise, tougher than you think. So you'll notice after a while that the right side muscles kind of burn. These are your rotators, your lateral rotators on that right leg. Let's do what, three more? Three. Good, inhale down. Exhale, lift. Two. Last one here. Again, she's keeping those shoulders down nice. Now hold it right here, keep it open. So you're stacked with the hips, nice and open, and you're gonna pulse the leg up. Lift and lift. Lift and lift. Lift, keep going, and four, three, two, last one. Drop that leg down. Get another little hamstring stretch. Just stretch that out, and then we'll move to the other leg. Alright, so bringing that right leg behind you. Inhale and exhale, lift it up. And I'll go ahead and do this set with her. Inhale down, exhale, lift up. So keeping that pelvis level, lift it up. Inhale down, exhale, lift. And lift. You got it. Lift. Keep the shoulders down. Last two. Last one here. Keep that leg up. And we're going to rotate and face towards that right side, opening up those hips as much as you can. Good. Bring it down and allow that right hip to lower more than the left side. And raise it back up. Keep your shoulders down this whole time. Inhale down. And exhale, lift up. Keep going. You're going to start to feel this on this left side in the hips. Those rotators working. Inhale down. Exhale, lift. Two more. Exhale, lift up. Last one here. Bring it back up. Keep that leg up. Let's pulse it for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Drop that foot down. Stretch it out. And that is it. That's your 10 minutes.